What you find is that the White House is trying to bamboozle the deal that the Republicans and the Democrats came together and the president blessed that he would sign. But once upon a time in America in 2008, there was a constitutional scholar from Illinois who ran for president. And he said that presidential signing statements, the very thing the president did to ignore this portion of the bill that he signed, was unconstitutional and wrong. He chastised President George W. Bush for doing it. But now that he's the president, he forgot what he campaigned on, another flip-flop on the part of this president. But he's using an unconstitutional method that he said in a signing statement to uphold the unconstitutional appointment of these czars, which are not subject to Senate confirmation. So he's doing exactly the opposite of what he promised as a candidate Obama. And look, the Republicans are going to be bamboozled if the president does it, because there's not enough time to overturn it. The only way you overturn it is either by legislation or the Supreme Court. I mean, that's not going to happen. The point is that this president,
well, no, the point is,
this president criticized George W. Bush for doing it.
He said he would not do it. Good negotiators.
He said he would not do it as president.
A deal's a deal,
and then he's doing it.
And the president believes this is within the purview of the deal. They don't. Quit whining. And next time around, deal with that issue.
How can you trust the president now on any other future deals that you make with this president who claims to be bipartisan? When you leave the Oval Office and the bill comes to his desk, the deal is suddenly changed by the flick of a president's pen.